All right, would you battle an up-and-comer? You know, you see a lot of rookies versus vets. You see a lot of blood, sweat, and tears where, you know, two tiers match up.
It's a lot of new cats and up-and-comers that is super fire. They can punch, they can perform, but they, oh man, this doesn't even sound right, but I'm going to say it, they can't beat me.
Mr. Stay, could you define real?
Yellow.
Oh, you're trying to be funny. You're lying still.
Please. You know what line is going to go next based on what he says.
I mean, it's just a freestyle. Like, it's a freestyle, and I'm padding it different. See, you got to think about possibilities. You know what I'm saying? I measure out every possibility. There's so many possibilities. What if you smash the mic out of my hand? You know what I'm saying? What if it's all type of possibilities you got to encounter, and I cover every possibility.
What do you consider being the GOAT, since you say you the GOAT?
What do I consider?
Being the GOAT. Like, I know they say greatest of all time.
Yeah, that's
but,
me.
Okay.
I have the most bars, most original bars. I have the most bar fest in the shortest amount of time with the toughest niggas of this generation.
What's wrong with Danny Mai? Look, first of all, what he's doing now, I already did. That's what these cats don't understand. How you put in more work? You're putting in the work I put in at 08, 09. You know, I battled Arsenal, Young Ill, Amzilla, A-Verb, Illmaculate, Passwords, or Awkwards in 1 year. Name that level of competition in 1 year. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know what these dudes is talking about. Like I can't do it. I've done it already. I've been there, done that. He's at the level I was doing in 2009-10. Now don't make me fucking... I'm getting mad because I like Danny Myers, too. You know, we were chopping it up in Boston. He's a cool dude. You know, I fuck with Danny Myers. I like his passion, his hunger, but if you want me to fuck Danny Myers up, Danny Myers, I will hurt you when I see you, lyrically.
Yo, what up, man? It's your boy Chris and Boss. You checking in, man? We did round three. We did round one. And now the best second rounds in battle rap, man, which I feel like is kind of a hard... Out of all three rounds, the second round is the hardest to do, in my opinion. It's like the fight back round. It's when you might be getting your ass beat in round one and you got to fight back in round two, man. So the best second rounds in battle rap. I got my top 10. Of course, I got some honorable mentions, man. So let's just get into it. And before I do that, man, I want to appreciate everybody that watched round three and round one. It's very hard to do, man. We're definitely not going to all agree. I always tell you, I just do a lot of blogs to create dialogue, man. So for people that feel like they can create a better list, you know what I'm saying? Give me your list. Do a video. Tweet me your list. Whatever it is, man, I definitely respond to it, man. So at the end of the day, it's all entertainment, and it's just something to create dialogue, man. There's a lot of fucking battles, and no, I do not watch every league, you know what I'm saying? So it may be some battles that I haven't seen with a crazy second, first, or third round. So at the end of the day, let me know what y'all think if I miss some battles. But let's get into these honorable mentions. Honorable mention number one. This battle was short notice, you know what I'm saying? It was on Blackout, on King of the Dot. It was short notice, and it just lets you know what happens when you got two guys that are at the top of their game, can freestyle, take people on short notice, don't duck any opponents, you know what I'm saying? And it came out to be one of the better battles on King of the Dot I've seen personally.
I'm in a depressive mood. I will bend his to a vendettas, to get this dude in another dentist room. Summon every special move I've been taking to hit him with the force of a Mack truck while I'm masked up like MF Doom.
DNA versus Sharon, man. Everybody knows, I think Sharon was supposed to battle someone else. I don't know, maybe Suge or something. I'm trying to remember that far back. Sharon was supposed to battle somebody else, and next thing you know, DNA pops up and he is on the card or whatever, and he battles Sharon. And what was a dope battle, you know what I'm saying? A lot of freestyles, a lot of rebuttals, battle put together on short notice. So we got to give these two dudes a lot of credit. And in my opinion, the second round for Sharon was very, very dope. And that's why I have it as an honorable mention, man. Really kind of put me on to let me see. Just I wasn't even that crazy about Sharon until I saw this battle. And then he went on to battle B-Magic and Shotgun Suge and battle a bunch of URL cats and Arsenal and all that. But this battle with DNA was like, it woke me up to who Sharon was, because I wasn't really following his career that much, although I had heard of him. But the DNA battle to me was a very, very dope battle, and what was looked like it was put together in less than a week. But shout out Sharon, and I got you on my honorable mention list as the second round in your DNA battle. Coming in next on the honorable mention list, this battle was another fire battle, I think a year or two ago or whatever. This battle was originally supposed to be on URL, ends up being on King of the Dot. You know what I'm saying? Differences between certain parties and URL prevented it from being on the URL channel. It ended up being damn near classic on the King of the Dot channel, man. So shout out to both these two guys. I told you every now and then I'll find a round where I pick both of their rounds, combine them, and give them a second round that's dope or whatever round is dope. In this situation, I took both of their rounds, combined it, and became an honorable mention, man. So without further ado, man, roll.
Baby boy, back on back. If Will slipped his hammer, knock him back on track. They calling me the future. YC, they throwing me racks on racks. Why you on Twitter every day, sucking dick, trying to get back on smack. Like, you get the picture? Cause you can get it stuck in your head like you know those songs. They've been waiting for these negatives to develop for oh so long. You beat me? No. Oh so wrong, cause when these cannons flash, it hit the nigga behind you too. That'll be his last photo bomb.
Big K versus Ill Will. This probably is on a lot of you guys' lists as far as the top 10. This was a very, very dope battle. Big K came out talking about you sucking dick to get back on smack, which was fire. DNA, you know, DNA exonerated you. DNA proved you wasn't the killer. Like, the nigga had haymakers in his fucking second round. Ill Will came back. He was fire in the second round too, about shooting a dude behind you. That'll be the last time he photobombed. That was fire. I you know, back in the day, I'd drop a nigga like you every day, like a No Limits CD. Nigga had some shit in that second round, man. I do feel like Big K won this battle overall, edged it, but it was a crazy second round from both these two guys, man. So I got it as an honorable mention. Salute to Big K and Ill Will. Next on the honorable mention list, one of my favorite battles that ever hit the URL channel, you know what I'm saying? You know, one is from New York, one is from St. Louis, and they came together and put together a classic. I have it as an honorable mention. Roll.
They call me Hitman. We between the five prints. This weapon not on safety. It ain't John Lynch. Night vision came with a scope. See behind tents. Michael Jackson Motown glove. You can't find prints. When they say the best, they say power. I won't lose, you wouldn't beat me with a time glitch.
Hitman Holla's second round versus Cortez is on my honorable mention list, and what was a fire second round for Hitman, you know, the Michael Jackson glove, Motown, you can't find Prince. What'd he say, this weapon not on safety, it ain't John Lynch, Michael Jackson Motown glove, you can't find Prince. And he, at the end, he was like, you wouldn't win this battle in Spanish, and he said the Spanish shit. And the ball game and ended the round, definitely a dope round, following what was a dope first round by him as well. And just what was a crazy battle from Hitman, man, really letting niggas know that this was, what, 2010, I think this battle was, something like that. So Hitman was definitely making his mark in the URL, early stages of URL, and letting niggas know that, well, even though I'm from St. Louis, I'm a force to be reckoned with, man. So the second round from Hitman in the Cortez battle on my honorable mention list. That's it for my honorable mentions, man. I know it's some other good second rounds out there that could be honorable mentions. Even SoulCon had a funny battle with this dude named Letho from back in the day. It was very funny. Second round, B-Magic and Chilla Jones had a nice second round. I'm trying to think who else. Ill Will, Johnny Alcatraz had a nice second round. There's been some other second rounds that, you know what I'm saying, could make your list. But for me personally, man, those are my honorable mentions. Ill Will versus Big K, Hitman versus Cortez, and Sharon versus DNA, man. So let's just get into the top 10. Coming in at number 10 on this list, this dude, Name Flip King, you know what I'm saying? He was definitely doing his thing when he came on the scene. This is my favorite Proving Ground battle.
If you don't like what I'm saying, then fight me now. See, I was with your boo, see, and she wiped me down. Let's get to it, just do it, Nike style. Gave it a cool Mo D, so how you like me now? He changed his name to Clean, get clean the fuck out. If Clean trip, I'ma knock clean the fuck out.
B-Magic's second round of this battle, which makes my list. B-Magic's second round in this battle is one of my favorite rounds in battle rap. You know what I'm saying? I'm not even super crazy about name flips because I feel like they're easy to do. But when you look at this battle was probably 4 years ago or something like that. So, you know what I'm saying? Like, I wasn't too tired of name flips at that time. And he worked the shit out of Q. You know what I'm saying? From QP in this fucking second round. And with the shit, I not clean the fuck out. Yo, he really spazzing in round two, man. One of my I still go back to this day and watch this second round just from this battle. It's the best round of the battle. And it's B-Magic second round. But QP was hilarious throughout the battle. Just the way he talk and the way he, you know what I'm saying, just expresses his bars. He did well as also. But B-Magic second round got it coming in number 10 on my list. Best second rounds of all time. Coming in number 9, this dude, a lot of people tweeted me and was like, yo, this dude is the second round king. You know what I'm saying? He definitely got some nice second rounds, but he only makes number 9 on my list. So without further ado, roll clip.
Chill, Will. If I'm still Will to still Will, headshots, he won't remember a round. Our young ill Will, I let the crowd choose how you get it. When I kill Will, should I give him a Smith like Emmett or Emmett Till Will? I don't have the time. Question, what's your 5 o'clock shadow gonna look like after 9? That's how I kill him.
I decided to combine two of Tay Rock's second rounds. You know what I'm saying? I felt like his Charlie Clip second round was crazy and his Ill Will second round is crazy. His Ill Will, both of them are very significant in battle rap, especially for Tay Rock, because when he battled Ill Will, I think he was an underdog. Ill Will was coming off UFF. I think he was an underdog. I think that battle was started to be what propelled Tay Rock. Tay Rock beating Ill Will started to propel him in the eyes of a lot of people as being an upper echelon, top tier kind of battle rap. He battled him, then he battled B-Magic, and then he went and battled Clips again, and then he started battling all these top names, and he became Smack's Gunner, including DNA, too. He started battling all these top names, and then he started becoming Smack's number one gunner. But I remember the Ill Will battle. He was definitely an underdog going into this battle. And he went crazy in the second round, man. Y'all remember the Emmett Till line? They be pouring, I be having niggas pouring yak out for you. Like, he went off in round two of this battle. The Charlie Clips battle, I felt like Clips took the first round. And I was like, you know, I'm going to see how this play out. And Tay Rock came back in round two and just spazzed. You know what I'm saying? So I definitely fucked with Tay Rock's second round. And a lot of people have him as a second round king. They was tweeting me that. But he just comes in at number 9 on his list. And I took both of his battles, the Ill Will and the Charlie Clips battle, and said these second rounds deserve to be on the list. I got them coming in at number 9. Coming in at number 8, I don't think this guy get enough credit for the second round run he went on at UFF. You know what I'm saying? I think a lot of people need to get his due. UFF was a pretty important stage for him from moving over from Spit That Heat and coming to URL. In his second round, I don't know if you niggas remember his second rounds, but you about to remember right now. He went off in his round twos of the whole UFF run. Roll clip.
Then I was going for the Deacon, but fuck it. I saw your mom's first. I pledged 44. Bitch longer than a song's verse. I said you about to meet your maker, but sing a song first. She said silver and gold. Bitch, that's the wrong verse. I shot the blood pressure test. I'm strapped with the arm squeezing. Just be prepared for war. This beyond reason. Top new name is Dot. I do the long reach and make it real.
This is another one coming in at number 8 where I decided to take two battles. I took the Chess battle and the Saga battle. You know, he battled Chess, he battled Saga, he battled Briz. You know what I'm saying? He went on this UFF run, he battled Snow. His Chess and Saga's round twos, some of the best round twos I've heard in battle rap. The storytelling shit. At this time, I wasn't tired of the storytelling shit. You know, I tell T-Top all the time now, when you battle Mav, my nigga, coming up, you gotta mix it up. When you battle these other dudes, you gotta mix it up, get more personal. That shit he had for Saga about going through the church and his mom and singing all that. And that shit he had for Chess about Chess being young and all this other stuff. Like, his second rounds was crazy, man. You know what I'm saying? I think he had the whole entire UFF going bananas in that room, man. So these are some of the rounds I go back to and watch. And I'd be like, this is the T-Top that put niggas on notice coming on the URL. Like, I'm not to be fucked with. And to me, he hasn't had a URL battle that lived up to his UFF rounds. You know what I'm saying? Some of the rounds he had at UFL were just crazy. You know what I'm saying? I know he had like a a very, very, I think, good third round versus Clips or something. He's had rounds here and there, but his UFF run has been some one of the best runs he's had on URL. So salute to T-Top. I got you coming in at number 8. Coming in at number 7, man, one of the best battles that's on the URL channel. I was in the building for it. I remember it like it was yesterday, how crazy this battle was in the building. And I have yet to see a battle live that has been better than this, you know what I'm saying? Unless I want to go to like maybe Hollow versus Lux, because I did see that live as well. But this was a crazy battle. When I look at the second round in this battle, one of the best second rounds I heard in battle rap, Road Clip.
The Boston battle scene is the worst thing popping. You play for the worst team and you the third string option. You getting your ass whipped and everybody on the first team watching. This We Clap Hammers here, Batman premiere. That clip release got at least 13 dropping.
This the try me face, get your life erased. Pencil style like a stencil, how your body trace. If I peek inside that Jeep you drive and I see papes, I'ma follow you with that chopper like a high speed chase.
JC versus Chilla, man. A lot of y'all feel like this is one of the best battles on the URL channel. I do as well. JC starts off the second round talking about how, you know, I can do what you do or whatever. And he starts doing a scheme with the fucking Facebook shit, and he goes to MySpace and Black Planet. The way he did that in the building was hilarious. You know what I'm saying? I think it was the first time people really broke down Chilla's style. And then Chilla comes back. He has a rebuttal. He also had a lot of nice little bars. I think he had a music scheme where he went through a bunch of instruments and he was like, this shit is music to my ears. He and You Die is music to my ears. He had a thing like, I'll follow you with the chopper, like trying to refer into the whole OJ situation, you know, with the chopper following OJ or whatever. I follow you with the chopper like a high speed chase or some shit like that. Crazy round from Chilla Jones, crazy round from JC. I combine them both and give you number 7 on my list, man. JC versus Chilla, both of their second rounds was crazy. You know, going through these first rounds, these third rounds, these second rounds, you could have picked either one of these rounds and put them on either list, first, second, and third. For me, I wanted to at least show some love because I know I didn't put them on the thirds. I know I didn't put them on the first. But this battle is a classic for a reason. And one of their rounds, if not both of their rounds, should be on your list. So for me, JC versus Chilla, the second round, I have it on my list coming in at number 7 for both of them. Salute to JC, salute to Chilla. Coming in at number 6, man, another classic battle. Over 8 million views, you know what I'm saying? A lot of y'all give these niggas a lot of hate. But at the end of the day, this is one of his better battles he's ever had, man. His second round, the wordplay, his cleverness, his, you know, his bars, his fucking performance, everything was A1 in this battle. Rope.
Let a nigga come to my city, talking them real nigga lines. I'ma show him in my city, we like to kill niggas' moms. See, all the real niggas is dead or in jail. Only a few real niggas rhyme. I never seen a clock in a casket or a cell. So in my book, smack ain't no such thing as real nigga time.
Oh, shit.
Now y'all wanna know why I ain't battle on the last smack? You can have that. That ain't even what I'm mad at. I change numbers if they can't Dow Jones. They stock drop like the NASDAQ. I pistol with your skull to calico, get his dad back, dad back, dad back.
As y'all can see, man, that's like my favorite clip. I love that fucking beat. Somebody sent me that Jadakiss beat and was like, yo, and edited it into the footage or whatever, into that trailer, and sent it to me. And ever since then, I always use that beat when I'm referring to this battle. That's a Jadakiss song for everybody that keeps emailing me, asking me, what instrumental is that from? That's from Jadakiss. It's featuring like two other guys on the track. I can't remember who, but it's definitely a dope track. Arsenal second round versus Shoddy Horror. If you remember, he went through this little wordplay thing.
Now, I could break down your life in 8 bars. You really ain't hard. You a fake fraud who used to play ball and battle rap. You the Ray Charles, meaning you ain't seeing nobody acting like beating me really ain't hard. Your chances slimmer than Big T in China running a marathon on a great ball.
That whole wordplay scheme was crazy. The smack angle was crazy. Do you remember he was going through his shit with URL? One of the few battles he had mentioned it in. A lot of y'all wonder why I ain't been on smack. That whole line about if you can't Dow Jones, that shit was crazy. You know what I'm saying? Like, I think he even went on the whole breaking down of Adam when he was talking about Shoddy Horror. Arsenal second round versus Shoddy Horror. One of my favorite rounds in battle rap. I got it coming in number 6. Coming in number 5, man. A lot of y'all really refer to this battle a lot when you mention this battle rapper. You definitely refer to this being one of his best lines he ever had in a battle. I gotta come to the number 5 on this list, Road Clip.
I checked his background, who riding for you? Check mine in the loop. I done bitch slap niggas livin' than you. Huh. Now watch how I wet that ass. Bring him out, hang him up. If your gorilla spend one day with us, trapped in a cage with us, they come back tamed as fuck, dangerous as chained up pups. I let that thing go buck till my wrist sprained and my finger cut. Y'all hostile crowd don't mean a thing to us. It ain't strange if I hit that angel dust, get my anger upturned. Juggernaut, his brain get crushed. Shots point blank range, bang, he fucked his soul fly. And I'm still firing. Even his guardian angels duck.
A-Verb versus SB, man. One of my favorite A-Verb battles that ever hit the YouTube. You know what I'm saying? You know, for Verb to basically come to New York, I think he was supposed to battle Head Ice, if I'm not mistaken. That falls through. Imagine if Head Ice would have got these bars. This nigga would have got 2-0. This was only a 2-round battle, but this nigga would have got 2-0 so easily in his battle. SB ends up getting these bars. This was back when niggas wasn't really doing no crazy personals and shit like that. Nigga just came straight to New York with battle bars. And for Verb to hit the streets in New York not being fearful, basically it was supposed to be Young Ill, Remedy, and Verb. And Verb took the challenge of saying, I'll give SB these bars, I'll battle SB. And what really set Verb's career on fire, because, you know, nigga had niggas in the street going crazy, Mook going crazy, SB. He wasn't bad, but he's forgettable in this battle because Verb's round, second round, is so crazy with the Guardian Angel lines and all the little shit, man. Yeah, so coming at number 5, man, I got A-Verb versus SB, one of the best battles from A-Verb and one of the best battles that we've seen pretty much in battle rap, man. Dope second round by A-Verb. Coming at number 4, man, another battle I was in the building for, man. Definitely highly anticipated. It's very rare we see a main event battle live up to the hype, man. So salute to these two.
We fuck with your energy, but the way you cram your bars to some fans is frustrating mentally. Slow down. It ain't all about the punch in your memory. I mean, we like the way you structure your similes, but sometimes you run through them literally. We fuck with your energy, but we question abilities. Oh, what I'm trying to tell you, P.S., don't rush your delivery.
Hollow to Don versus Lux, man. I love in the second round when Hollow started breaking Lux down and started pulling out the notes saying, you know, I got a note for you, UPS, don't rush your delivery. That shit was classic from Hollow, you know what I'm saying, the way he set that up. And what was a dope second round for him. Lux had a nice second round too. Y'all came front. Like, this battle was like this. I think I like Hollow a little bit more in round two, to be honest with you. I think that's a round I think I gave Hollow in the battle as far as first and third. I don't know, man. It's a battle I really don't call, but I know I felt like Hollow kind of edged this round just on the creativity of the whole breaking down Lux style. But dope battle from both of them. I like Lux second round as well. I mean, just bar after bar after bar, these niggas was coming with it, man. So salute to Lux, salute to Hollow. Got to come to number 4 on my list. We are coming down to the top 3 second rounds of all time, man. Coming in at number 3, this battle, another dope battle from a St. Louis dude, you know what I'm saying? This was actually one of the biggest battles on URL at the time. It was a grudge match. Niggas was doing blog after blog versus each other, and they finally hit the stage. It was the first time this dude, really the first time they pretty much hit the URL stage, and it's crazy that this battle is 6 years old.
I say, oh shit, anytime now, Arsenal should be approaching him. He should take that angle and smash him that way. In my head, I started coaching him. He turned around, saw Rex, saw me, he did this. Man, I saw the ghost in him, heart beating fast, he nervous, I'm losing hope for him. I gave him benefit of the doubt, like, maybe he's too sober. He don't want to fuck up the battles, he probably waiting till it's over. We get outside, that's on my mom's children, and nigga wave by to every rapper in the
The second round of Hitman Holla is bananas. Came out in 2009, man. It was a lot of shit talking between Hitman, a lot of shit talking between Arsenal. You almost felt like this kind of had the grudge match, but it was going to be a fight if these two niggas was in the same room with each other. And Hitman's storytelling shit about Rex. And anytime now Arsenal should be approaching him, he should take that angle, smack him that way. In my head, I started coaching him. Classic from Hitman. And then the aggression that he had as well from the rest of the round was just bananas. And the way he ended with the whole I put on jerseys for real ball game, because he obviously he played college ball, crazy. First time being on URL for Arsenal as well, for him to come over. He had been battling all these other leagues, Grind Time, everywhere else, and he comes on the URL. First battle was Hitman, And it was a big battle, man. It really put Hitman on the map and elevated him to kind of superstar status to be able to beat the million view Arsenal. So salute to Hitman. I got him coming in number three. Number two on this list, man. This dude has already been on the list one time. That just tell you, that just lets you know how crazy this nigga rounds can be.
Roll check clip. The bets, they got me winning like 10-5. I've been advised, he like to do dumb shit. He loves to freestyle, likes to improvise. My temper rise, we roll up in black tinted rides. Hop out, niggas get paralyzed, not penalized. Large clips, enterprise, cars flip. Injure guys, I beam his whole team up. Starship Enterprise. I'm too complex for it, even when I'm simplified. If New York is such a jungle, tell me this. How the fuck do niggas like him survive? We terrorize. We terrorize timid guys, cotton shirt, linen guys, light-skinned, slender guys. The target's been identified. It could be a long line of rappers who getting signed. If he in the front, I'ma jump him like, shut up, bitch, I've been in line.
You will be hard-pressed to find a better round than A-Verb's second round versus Hollow the Don. You know, I actually got him beating Hollow 2-0, you know what I'm saying? I wanted to talk to Hollow about that because I know he fought back and gave you that crazy rebuttal with the Eminem shit. You know what I'm saying? That was crazy, but it was not enough to beat A-Verb's second round. A-Verb pretty much washed him in the first round and won the second round as well in what was a close second round. But his second round is so fire to me. And I'm like, this is the A-Verb that everybody fell in love with as a battle rap fan and was like, yo, this nigga is damn it. When this nigga is like this, he's unbeatable, dog. Niggas cannot fuck with this particular A-Verb right here. Unfortunately, we don't see enough of it. You know what I'm saying? But it is what it is. Coming in number two, A-Verb, second round versus Hollow the Don. Well, we down to number one, man. And if you've been following my channel, then you already should know what number one is. You know what I'm saying? Because it's only been a dude that I've been supporting and supporting and supporting through the ups and the downs. I ain't jumped off the bandwagon. Roll clip.
Now it's a rumor going round. Tell me, is it true, my friend? They say you put cardboard in that motherfucker to make it look new again.
Stanky Yankee Fitted. This is such a fire second round. My favorite second round. Y'all niggas don't understand how many times I have watched this battle. You know what I'm saying? Y'all, I don't think y'all niggas understand. I realize Young Ill may not have won the battle because now I go back and look at it. I'm like, yo, this shit was mad close. Rich was talking some shit. The second round, he got killed though. And when I go back and watch this, man, I'm like, I don't even know if Rich Dollars wears Yankee hats no more, my nigga. Like, the nigga might have just switched teams after this round. You know what I'm saying? That's just how crazy it was. If I'm not mistaken, I'm trying to think, did he show up at the next battle with I'm trying to think. He battled X Factor next in Detroit. And I'm not really even sure if the nigga even wore a Yankee hat in that battle. I gotta go back and look at that battle. Maybe he did, maybe he did. I don't know. But I know niggas was like, yo, you better not wear that stinky Yankee fitted no more. And that shit was just crazy for Young Ill to come in there and steal the room and destroy this round. You know what I'm saying? The way he set it up with the phone call and the...
Oh, this what this bitch be on? Texting ill, don't get me wrong, but me and Richie just don't get along. Get home, I let him lick the click, but he don't get the bone. That's cause he eats, sleep, beat his meat, piss and shit with that same stanky Yankee fit on.
Cardboard to make it look new again. Like, my nigga, the creativity of this round, crazy. You know what I'm saying? Crazy. My favorite second round in battle rap. There ain't no second round you can tweet me that I would like more than this round right here. Shout out to Young Ill, man. I ain't just battled Daylight. Footage will be coming out soon on that. You know what I'm saying? Stay tuned to the Unbiased Review channel for more details on that battle. And he is on Born Legacy 3, so you're going to see more of Young Ill. And that is my top 10 list, man. Let's debate it. Let's discuss it. I want to do some more of these lists. I don't really know. Niggas want me to do like more battle records. Niggas like, yo, you need to do Tay Rock. You need to do Surf and shit like that. I'm going to do a few more battle records coming up soon. I don't know who I want to do next. I'm thinking about doing like Conceited or somebody. But I need to do some more battle records. I want to do some other shit, man. Maybe best, you know, top 10 body bags. A whole lot of different list I want to do. I don't want to just recap battles. You know what I'm saying? I tell a lot of people that try to get into this blog game, you got to be able to separate yourself. At this rate, like, nobody is doing these kind of lists but me. You know what I'm saying? Nobody is really kind of giving it to you like I'm giving it as far as that's concerned. A lot of niggas are breaking down like, yo, who you think won the battle? So for me, I try to give you a little bit more, and that's how my channel evolved to even being where it is now, and then it moved to Untold Truths and different shit like that. So I'm just trying to do other I feel like for me, I'm a better topic blogger. I can give me a topic, give me a seven unanswered question, something like I can break that shit down crazy. I don't know if I'm the best reviewer of a battle. I'm smart. I know battle rap. I can give my opinion. But you give me a topic, I can destroy a topic. You know what I'm saying? Even if y'all niggas don't agree, I can sell a motherfucking topic blog. And that's probably my lane more than anything else. But you know what I'm saying? Just try to give y'all niggas a little bit of variety, man. So I appreciate all the support. Appreciate the hate. Appreciate the tweets, the love, everything else, man. I see it all. So at the end of the day, man, thanks for the support. And follow me on Twitter, subscribe to the channel. I'll let your boy.